was digging through my archives and I stumbled across a brand concept that I created years ago, but I never got printed. Well, with the power of DTF today, it's way more possible. How you guys doing? My name is Stan Banks from T-Shirt Side Hustle, and I help people start T-shirt businesses from home, wherever you at. And in this video, we're gonna go ahead and use some DTF transfers to knock out a brand design concept right after the intro. Into it, but before we do, you guys know that you to do for me. I need you to like this video, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff, because I make videos like this all the time. Yes, I mean all the time. So today I wanted to do something as a little pet project. As you guys know, I typically am not a deep like fashion style brand person, right? I like clothing brands or niche market brands, right? I talk about niches bring riches in the book and in the masterclass, but I like to make brands that are geared towards a purpose, a cause, or like a mission or something like that, right? So I've had this in the tuck for a long time. It doesn't really fall in the clothing brand aspect, but it could, because it's kind of like a more generalized concept, right? In the past, I had HBCU tees, I had First State of Mind, and I'm gonna be launching First State of Mind all over again. I'm gonna be bringing you guys along on that journey as I relaunch this brand. And I may just be partnering with someone else to create a new version of Build a Brand that you guys get to watch. And the thing I love about Build a Brand in the past is that I had people at different stages in their business, and this one might just be from the true early on inception of a concept all the way throughout building the brand around that. So I'm excited about that. But this here is like something that I wanted to do and create. And we had this artwork for quite some time now. And the beauty about having your own equipment, the beauty about being able to kind of like put some concepts together and making your money other places, is that you already have everything. So if you ever have an idea, you can go ahead and create that idea and just see what happens with it, right? I may never sell this, I may sell it, but the beauty is I get to wear it and create it. And with DTF today, that is way more accessible across all bins of artwork, right? You don't have to just stick to vinyl and different things like that. So we have transfers from Marathon Dot Supply. If you're looking to get some transfers, you're looking to get them fast, you're looking for DTF transfers, and you like the channel, make sure you visit marathon.tshirtsizehustle.com. That's the link. Let them know over there that I sent you. All right. So this here is the concept. It is called Black Goat. And the concept comes around like the black sheep of the family and turn it into like the black goat. Right. And the beauty about this is like you thought I was a sheep, turned out to be a goat. Goats don't separate themselves. Goats hang around together, right? So I got a bunch of other designs, but the main concept here was to go with the G for goat, with the goat eating money, got a little earring in his ear, and then the G is for goat as well. So I got a left chest and a big chest version. I'm thinking I want to go with the left chest, and I could have put this on the front, this on the back. I could go left chest, this on the left chest, this on the back. But let me know down in the comments, where would you place what? All right, would you use the big G, the little G? Would you put this on the front with the big G on the back? How would you lay this out if this was something that you were working on? If you wanna pick one up, I don't know, DM me on Instagram. I probably won't have it available for a site today. I'm printing with a sample shirt from T-Style. This is their Essential Street Tee. One thing I like about it is it has the streetwear fit, which is the little boxier fit, but it's really super soft. So that is something that I'm looking to wearing this, and I wanted to use this shirt specifically for this design. And then I have some stuff that we're gonna be sampling out for first. I got some dope videos coming for you guys about what I would do from the inception of an idea, how I would sample out a bunch of different ideas. So I have that stuff here ready for you guys. The laying out of a gang sheet, all of that will be included in that video coming up for you guys. Again, these transfers are from Marathon. I think today, before I jump into what we're gonna do today, these here are for hats. So I have these hats from Hat Vendor. You can pick them up and let them know that I sent you over there. That's hatvendor.tshirtsizer.com. It'll be linked up down in the description. I'm going to do these a little bit different. I'm not going to use the hat press. My guy over at Bird Prints showed a video where how he was kind of like using one of these pads here and put it inside of there and was using a hand iron. So I'm going to step outside my box, my comfort zone, but I got a new way, what I would call the craft, or maybe I should change the name to like the Hustler's palette, right? But a palette that you can get and use with your hand iron and be able to do hats, to be able to do neck labels if you're using one of those palettes and stuff like that. So we got some hats and we got the concept for this and this. I don't know how I lay it out, but we'll worry about that a little bit later. So let me move that out of the way. I'm actually just gonna just put it back here. And let's talk about our project for the day. Our project for the day is to run something with these prints. And I, for today, I don't think I want to go with the big G in this on the back. I could go with something like this here. I could put that there, or I could go left chest and spin this around the side here. I think I want to do that, right? I was going to put this on the back, just straight across the back normal, but we got to get some new placement. So I think I'm going to go wrap this around. So if this is on my left chest, right, left chest, and I wrap this around the right side here, I think I should do that. I think that looks pretty fair. That sticker's been on this shirt for a while. And so let's go ahead now. Let's transition over to the heat press. And let's go ahead and press it. I think I like this placement for the start. We'll see how it comes out. And we'll get this thing rolling. So give me 2 seconds. Let me reposition everything. Let's get on the press. And let's press up some Marathon DTF transfers. Let's do it. All right, so I got everything set up here and situated. Like I said, we're going to go left chest, right side. So let me move that out the way. Let's push that back. Let's go ahead and grab our shirt. I'm going to give this a pre-press. Typically, I normally don't. I'm just going to give it a pre-press for the simple fact that it's just been sitting around here. I don't know what's going on with it. All right, we're going to go ahead. I know you guys want a detailed video on how I line things up. I'm gonna give you guys a quick run through, but I will have way more specific video coming for you guys soon. If you want that, let me know down in the comments. Say, yo, I need that alignment video, right? No tools, just trusting in my hands. 4 fingers, 3 fingers, measure it up. All right, nice little pre-press there. So I'm hanging the edge off and I'm feeling for the shoulder seams on both sides to make sure that the shirt feels straight and even and smooth. And we're good to go there. I'm pressing at 320 degrees for 15 seconds. We got a wide range. When you get your transfers, they will come with some application instructions. And it's a wide range of what you can do. So I'm going to go 4 fingers down from the collar here. And actually, this is a little bit taller. So I'm probably going to go a little bit higher. I'm going to go like 3.5 fingers from the collar. Put my hand down the center line here, and I want to be about 1 inch off center, right? I got this from Big Brando. This is how I line it up, but I do normally check to make sure that the center line is down, kind of like the center of the collar here. I got that from Big Brando. Again, I like to be 1 inch off center, and it kind of turned out to be the same exact thing. So shout out to him for that little technique. That's how I kind of just check to make sure I like the placement of it. So we're going to press this on our left chest here. Whoa, got this thing on a little, took a little muscle in there to get it down. And then once this is done, I'm going to transition to that side. Like I talked about, I normally do not thread, but for this side, I am going to thread it just because of the way I don't want to press it through to the other side. Let that cool down. Right now we're running with the cold peel, so let that cool down. Right, so now we got our side here, and I'm thinking... Honestly, I'm thinking to go probably about right there. So maybe just like 1.5 inches off this bottom seam. So I don't got to get too crazy with it. Go about 1.5 inches from there. So about right there from the seam. So that's about 1 inch. All right, you can go about right there. Make sure it looks like the text is slided there, and then I'm gonna move this over a little bit. I guess I should fold this one. I typically don't do this. Whenever you are working with a single design, you can take more time just to make sure that it's perfect. I just wanna make sure I'm centered where I want it to be. About an inch and a half. Put that line on this sideline, center line there. And then make sure that it looks like it's about flat in comparison. That looks good. Again, we're gonna load this in. Give it a press, same deal. And then once we're done there, we're gonna go ahead and give it a side press. And then after that, we get to try it on, see what we're looking like. See how y'all feeling about it. All right. Bow. So this is good to go. Woo! That joint is smooth. Looking good right there. Looking good to good. Okay. For the post press, I don't even worry about like making sure that it's lined right or anything like that. I just lay it back on the pallet. I don't know what happened to this side there, but I just lay it back on the pallet, make sure the collar's not off. And just try to make sure the box is kind of like in the same spot. Just gonna give it a post press. Ugh, man, I should loosen it up, huh? I ain't learned my lesson. I'm gonna give it a post press for about 3 or 5 seconds. Something slight there. And that thing feels good. Now we're gonna go ahead and get on our side print here. Good to go there. Let's get out of press. Looking good. So we got our side print. We got our chest print. And we rocking with the T-Style Essential Streetwear T-shirt. And now let's take a look at it with it on. All right, man. So this thing looks good. I really like this shirt for like some loose fitted shirts. Feels really good. It's feeling really soft. Kind of don't need this anymore. But let me know down in the comments what you guys think about this. Would you rock it? Does this look good? Nice little concept. Got the sleeve thing there, or the rather not the sleeve, the side print right there going around. Looking good right there. We got the left chest with the black gold on there. Looking good. So if you want to sample out something that you're going to use for a brand or an idea that you have, you get the artwork created. Detail transfers makes it really, really good with no limitation color-wise or detail-wise. This could have been a photo of myself. This could have been 15 colors. I'm a simple guy, so I like, you know, just the black, the whites, and every once in a while we do switch it up. So look forward to seeing some more stuff like that in the video. You can probably click right here somewhere and that'll be available for you guys. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think about this brand, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. This has been your boy Stan Banks from T-Shirt Side Hustle. Peace.
The T-Shirt Side Hustle team would like to give a huge shout out to its contributing members.